Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. The Islamic law of inheritance has been detailed out in Surah Nisa of the Quran, and we find that the various shares of a person have been mentioned in the Quran in detail. Now, there is a case against the Quran which people make in various other areas also, and they have made this in this particular area also, and that is that people say that Islam is a religion in which women are regarded to be second-rate citizens or second-rate people or second-rate human beings vis-a-vis men, and therefore it has relegated them back in a lot of things. Now, for example, in this particular area, in this particular issue of the law of inheritance, one of the objections which is raised is, in favor of this objection is, that the share of a daughter is half that of a son. And this, of course, would show that Islam's treatment towards women is something in which it regards women to be inferior to men. Another issue which I would discuss here, the previous one I have already discussed in one of my other talks, what I'd like to discuss here is another objection, a very similar objection, which says that the share of a husband, as per the Quran, is twice as that of his wife. So therefore, is not the Quran making a distinction, a discrimination in this matter? Now, the answer to this question lies in the whole philosophy of the law of inheritance, which is stated very clearly in the Quran. The Quran says, أَبَاؤُكُمْ وَأَبَنَاؤُكُمْ لَا تَدْرُونَ أَيُّهُمْ أَقْرَبُ لَكُمْ نَفَعًا. It says that you do not know as to which of your fathers, your forefathers and your amongst your children, they are near to you in benefit. Now, the philosophy of this distribution of inheritance, as the Quran has said in this verse, is based on the closeness of benefit which a person or a relationship has with the deceased. So therefore, the Quran says, although this philosophy is something which can be understood, of course, by human intellect, however, human intellect is unable to know how much closeness of benefit a particular relationship carries for the deceased. So therefore, for this reason, the Quran has detailed out the shares of all very near kins which lie vis-a-vis the deceased. Now, in this case, of course, it is very obvious from the Quran that the husband has been given the twice share with regard to his wife. Now, for example, if a wife dies and there are children, the husband would receive 1/4 of her inheritance. And if there are no children, he would receive 1/2 of her inheritance. On the other hand, if the husband dies and there are children, the wife would receive 1/8 of the husband's share. And if there are no children, then she'll receive 1/4. So therefore, one can see from this comparison that in both cases, the husband always receives twice that of his wife. Now, is this not a case of discrimination, as people say? The answer again to this objection lies on this philosophy which I have just stated earlier, which says that it is primarily the closeness of benefit which is found in certain relationships, and on the basis of this, the shares are decided. Now, we know that in case of a husband and wife relationship, as far as companionship is concerned, both are equal companions to each other. However, a husband is given one additional responsibility with which the wife has not been given, and that responsibility is to earn the livelihood or to take the financial responsibility of the family. In other words, the wife, although she can contribute financially, she can earn, of course, but she is not obligated to earn. On the other hand, it is mandatory upon the husband by Islam that he has to be the breadwinner of the family. He has to earn for the family. So therefore, it is because of this fact that the share of the husband has been stated as twice as that of his wife, simply because he on him lies the responsibility of earning for the family. So on the basis of this, we can easily conclude that there is no discrimination between a husband and a wife. As far as companionship is concerned, as far as their being human beings are concerned, they're absolutely equal. There is no discrimination. This twice share has been given to the husband simply because he has been given this additional responsibility for earning for the family, and therefore for the wife, the share of the benefit of a husband is much more than what a wife could have been for her husband, simply because in this case, as I have said, the husband has been entrusted with the responsibility of earning for the family. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين والمسلمات.